I knew it. Alfred! Alfred! Don't you think it's about time you got up? Or do you want to stay in bed all day? Not that I've got any doubts about your being lazy enough to stay in bed forever. Goodness knows what time it is. We haven't even got any way of telling the time since you pawned your watch like a fool. The last valuable thing we had, and you knew it. It's been nothing but pawn, pawn, pawn with you. Anything to put off getting a job. Anything to get out of going to work like a man. Excuse for you to make a beast of yourself. But what was the use in pawning your watch if all you wanted with the money was to waste it and buy a drink? Hurry up! Don't take long to get breakfast these days. All we got this morning is bread and jam and coffee. And you wouldn't even have that if it weren't for me sewing my fingers off. The bread's stale. I hope you'll like it. You don't deserve any better. But I don't see why I should suffer. The coffee will be ready in a minute. You needn't expect me to wait for you. What on earth are you doing all this time? Well, you're almost dressed, at any rate. I expected to find you back in bed. That'd be just like you. How awful you look this morning. Oh, for heaven's sake, shave! You're disgusting! You look like a tramp. No wonder no one will give you a job. And I don't blame them when you don't even look halfway decent. There's plenty of hot water right here. You've got no excuse here. Look at your hand tremble. You'd better give up drinking. You can't stand it. It's just your kind that gets the DTs. Now that would be the last straw. Look at the mess you've made of this floor. Cigarette butts, ashes all over the place. Why can't you put them on a plate? No, you wouldn't be considerate enough to do that. You never think of me. You don't have to sweep the room. That's all you care about. Hurry up. It must be nearly time for me to go, and if I'm late, liable to lose my position. And then I couldn't support you any longer. And then you'd have to go to work or something dreadful like that. What I want to know is whether you're going to look for a job today or not. You know your family won't help us anymore. And they've had enough of you too. I'm about sick of all this life. I have a good notion to go home. I wasn't too proud to let them know what a failure you've been. You, the millionaire Roland's only son, the Harvard graduate, the poet, the catch of the town. Ha! Oh, there wouldn't be many envy my catch if they knew the truth. Now, what has our marriage been, I'd like to know? Even before your millionaire father died owing everyone in the world money, certainly never wasted any of your time on your wife. I suppose you thought I ought to be glad you were honorable enough to marry after getting me into trouble. Now, you were ashamed of me with your fine friends, because my father's only a grocer. That's what you were. Well, at least he's honest, which is more than anyone can say about yours. You hoped everyone would think you'd been forced to marry me and pity you, didn't you? You didn't hesitate much about telling me you loved me, making me believe your lies before it happened, did you? So you made me think you didn't want your father to buy me off, as he tried to do. I know better now. I haven't lived with you all this time for nothing. It's lucky the poor thing was born dead after all. What a father you'd have been. But There's one other at least, and she can't hope to marry you now. How about Helen? Don't look at me like that. Yes, I read her letter. And what about it? I got a right to. I'm your wife. And I know all there is to know, so don't lie. You needn't stare at me so. You can't bully me with your superior airs any longer. Only for me, you'd be gone without breakfast this very morning. You never did have any gratitude for what I've done. The coffee's ready. I'm not going to wait for you. And I wouldn't if you were half a man. By rights, I ought to be lying on my back instead of you. For you know how sick I've been this last year. And yet you object when I take a little something to keep up my spirits. Didn't even want me to take that tonic I got at the drugstore. I know you'd be glad to have me dead and out of your way. And then you'd be free to run after all these silly girls who think you're such a wonderful, misunderstood person. This Helen and the others. There. I knew you'd cut yourself. It'll be a lesson to you. You know you oughtn't to be running around nights shaving, drinking with your nerves in such awful shape. What makes you so pale? What are you staring at yourself that way in the mirror for? Oh, for goodness sake, wipe that blood off your face. It's horrible. There, that's better. Oh, I never could stand the sight of blood. You better give up trying. Go to a barber shop. Your hand shakes dreadfully. Why do you stare at me like that? Still mad about that letter? Well, I had a right to read it. I'm your wife. I knew all this time you were running around with someone. Your lame excuses about spending the time at the library didn't fool me. Who is this Helen, anyway? One of those artists? Or does she write poetry, too? Her letter sounds that way. I'll bet she told you your things were the best ever, and you believed her like a fool. Is she young and pretty? I was young and pretty too, when you fooled me with your fine poetic talk. But life with you would soon wear anyone down. Oh, what I've been through. Breakfast is ready. Breakfast! Your coffee will be cold. What are you doing? Still shaving, for goodness sake? You better give it up. One of these mornings, you'll give yourself a serious cut. Well, I'll have to run as soon as I've finished eating. One of us has got to work. Now, are you going to look for a job today? Or aren't you? I should think some of your fine friends would help you if they think you're so much. No, I guess they just like to hear you talk. Thank you. for this Helen, whoever she is. But haven't you got any feelings for other people? What will her family say? And I see she mentions them in her letter. So what is she going to do? Have the child? Or go to one of those doctors? That's a nice thing, I must say. Where can she get the money? Is she rich? You won't tell me anything about her, will you? Much I care. Come to think of it, I'm not so sorry for her after all. She knew what she was doing. She isn't any schoolgirl like I was, from the looks of her letter. Does she know you're married? Of course, all of your friends know about your unhappy marriage. Now, I know they pity you, but they don't know my side of it. They'd talk differently if they did. Well, this Helen must be a fine one if she knew you were married. So what does she expect then? That I'll divorce you and let her marry you? Does she really think I'm crazy enough for that? After all you've made me go through. I guess not. And you can't get a divorce from me. And you know it. No one can say I've ever done anything wrong. She deserves to suffer. That's all I can say. And I'll tell you what I think. I think your Helen is no better than a common streetwalker. That's what I think. Did you cut yourself again? Serves you right. Well, I've got to be running along. This is a fine life for me to be leading. I won't stand for your loafing any longer. You've overturned all the water all over the floor. Now don't say you haven't, I can hear it dripping on the floor. Alfred,